Well, gee, Frank, what tipped it off? Was it maybe the sound of the air going through the gas pump, perhaps, or the solenoid switch tapping all by itself?
You were supposed to fill up the tank before we left.
The tank is filled, Frank. Look at the gauge.
The gauge is broken. You were supposed to fix it.
You didn't fix it, Frank?
You were supposed to fix it.
You were supposed to fix it, Frank.
Dad, just admit,
Frank,
okay?
You were supposed to fix it.
You were supposed to fix it.
Right now, we're stuck in the middle of nowhere.
We are not in the middle of nowhere, Frank. This is America. There is no nowhere, America, Frank. That's in Canada, there's nowhere. Here, there's always somewhere. It's too built up. We're 50 miles outside of Gary, Indiana.
And going nowhere fast.
Frank, we're 50 miles from where Brent Lawrence's sister rented that car. All we have to do is find Cassie, get her, pick her up, get her to testify against Alan Spaulding, and have him in jail to the year 2010.
You know what? I think there's a gas station 5 miles back.
Oh, well, you go back there, Frank, because I'm going to go up here, because there's one up the mile.
Why would you take a chance when we know there's one right
Frank,
there?
Frank, I know American roads, Frank. I'm an American. I've driven these
Well, you
roads.
Want to know something? I'm not going to listen to you this time. Okay, you couldn't find the White House if we were on Pennsylvania Avenue, all right? You left Springfield without putting gas in the car, and you got us lost twice. Man, you're no more king of the road than you are man of the year or father of the year.
Good morning, Ms. Lindsay Hyphen Reed.
Good morning, Mr.
Whatever, yeah.
How many times are we going to go through this?
How did you sleep?
Like a baby.
Oh, you cried all night, huh?
Yes, you
did. Well, you certainly don't act like no baby. My wife. My wife. I've got a wife.
I've got a husband.
It's going to take some adjusting just to do both our parts. What do you say we just spend the rest of the day right here like this, just adjusting?
Okay, by me. Then maybe we could take a picnic out by that lake and maybe ride some horses. And
okay. I also saw in the brochure they got some Native American caves nearby.
You want to go in a cave?
Yeah, well, I want to maybe get a souvenir for Ben from honeymoon or something.
Okay, just as long as we get back in time for a nice long nap.
Oh, I love your definition of nap. You're on. Don't spoil that cave,
oh, and
too.
Tonight what? They're playing Gershwin in the garden.
Yeah, we can't miss that.
Right. Okay. You're very good at this honeymoon thing.
Well, thank you.
Never thought I'd be able to keep you away from the paper this long. Paper? Mr. Type A.
The paper? What paper?
Come on. You're the workaholic in this family, not me.
No.
Yeah.
You don't know me at all. I haven't thought about the paper or Springfield or any of that stuff for the longest time.
What's that?
Oh, that's room service. I called them.
Rooms? Really? Reason number 95 why I love you. Blueberry pancakes, I hope.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, good. Remind me to divorce you in about 50 years. Oh, boy. Oh, a newspaper.
Yeah, I thought. Oh, my God, look what we're missing. Alan Spaulding's been arrested.
Thank you.
Well, what took you so long?
Alan, I got here as early as I could. You feeling any better this morning?
I don't know. You tell me. What's the agenda?
Bail hearing's been set.
How long is it going to take? Look, I better be a free man by lunchtime.
Alan, I've been in touch with your banker. We have some red tape that we're going to have to deal with first. See these? You got to fill them out before any funds are released.
Why can't I write a check, that's all?
It won't cover it. Alan, it's my best guess that we're going to be dealing with a very high bail.
It's ridiculous.
The courts figure that if your assets are tied up, you're not going anywhere.
Where's my sister?
I don't know. I haven't seen her.
She knows what I'm going through, and she promised me she would help me. Look, Sid, I'm not going back to that jail cell. I don't care what happens. I am not going back.
It's very good.
You really think so?
Yeah.
I tried to keep your name out of it, but it was kind of hard, you know?
Well, I knew that when I asked you to write it. Great. This is just what we need.
Look, Alexandra, if you're here to give Tangi some more grief, I suggest you turn around and you walk right outside that door.
What I have to say to Ms. Hill is private.
Go home,
no,
Mother.
No, not
please.
Until she hears me out. Tangi, this is about Alan, and I'm asking, please. It's okay, Nick. Thank you. In here, please.
Thank you. Macy.
You shouldn't have deceived me, Macy.
Anthony's got a big night plan.
You're gonna give me a night of passion.
Say your prayers.
A night of closure.
Because it could be the end for you.
Ready or not, baby, here comes Tony.
In a bold and beautiful moment.
Well, first I'd like to apologize for overreacting yesterday. I perhaps rushed to judgment there.
It wouldn't be the first time.
Look, I didn't come here to play a cat and mouse game with you, Tanji. I'm truly sorry. It's just been a very difficult time for me, for my brother.
You don't need to tell me that.
Of course not. I'm sure it hasn't been easy for you either. I mean, much time as you and Alan have spent together, Look, I know you must have some feelings for him.
My feelings are none of your business.
Of course. Of course, I know you're a very private person. I see that.
Don't think that I'm overly sympathetic for a man who sold out his loved ones.
Oh, please, come on. This is also a man who brought you into our home, Tanji. I mean, he confided some of his deepest secrets in you.
That's the problem. He lied to me. He told me he would change, that he would be different because of me.
Well, welcome to the real world, but Tanji, Alan isn't perfect, but he's not evil. He doesn't deserve this. Brent Lawrence used him every bit as much.
Oh, wait a second. He emotionally and financially supported a man who raped a young girl. The same man who held a gun to my head. You can't pass him off as some sort of a victim. Why don't you talk to your son? Your son even thinks that Alan was faking the whole jail cell tantrum. He thinks that everything that Alan has done since he's gotten out of jail has been an act, including this visit by you.
You certainly are some self-righteous guy. All right, Tanji, I'm going to tell you some truth, and believe me, you're going to listen.
Alan, you're going to have to stay as calm and cool as you can.
It's easier said than done, Sid.
Well, you're going to have to, unless you want to wind up in a place worse than jail.
It doesn't exist.
Well, yeah, have you ever seen the inside of the state mental hospital, huh? The prison section?
Where is my sister? She promised to be here.
Alan, will you forget about Alex?
She said she understood, but she doesn't. It's Tanji. She's still holding this grudge about me and Tanji.
Oh, Alan, you're not making any sense, all right? But you better, because if not, you're finished.
Look, I'm fine. I'm totally prepared for this.
I won't lie to you. It won't be easy.
Never mind that, Sid. You can do it. You got to come through for me.
Maybe I will. Maybe I won't.
Oh, you're an excellent attorney. The best there is, Sid. That's why I pay you so highly. Now, is there something else on your mind?
Alan, I'm going to do my best for you at this bail hearing, but there's one thing that I have to know the truth about.
Ask away.
Did you get Jilly fired from her TV job out in Los Angeles?
You know the answer to that.
No, I don't think so, Alan. I wouldn't have asked a question if I did.
Don't play naive, Sid. You've been around here long enough to know how things work.
You admit that you had her fired?
I figured Julie already knew. She never misses an opportunity to give me a little dig about it. I thought she might have told you.
I didn't believe her.
It's because you chose not to. Because you didn't want anything to get in the way if you're working with me.
Okay, wait a minute. You stop right there, Alan, all right? I am ambitious. I'm not ashamed of that. But in no way am I greedy enough to sacrifice Jilly's career for my own. I don't play like that, even for you.
Since when? Oh, come on, Sid. You should be thanking me. I got Jilly back here as much for you as I did for me.
Are you arrogant?
Get off of your high horse. You're in love with a woman.
I'm going to marry her, Alan.
Yes, but you wouldn't be if I hadn't pulled a few strings and brought her back.
Look, huh? I would have moved out there, and you know it.
Yes, and you would have been miserable, scrounging up paralegal work for some egomaniacal showbiz attorney.
Yeah, and it would have been my choice, too.
No, Sid, it wouldn't have been your choice. It would have been hers. Your choice would have been here to stay and work in the old neighborhood. Make a fortune working for me, you would have hit the jackpot.
Oh, Alan, please, all right? Stop making this sound like you did this for me. You did it for yourself.
Of course I wanted you for my attorney. But I also wanted what was best for you and Jilly.
You play God with other people. Don't you dare do it with me.
Right. Do you want Jilly to go back to Los Angeles? All it would take is a phone call. I mean, it's up to you. If you want to leave Springfield,
abandon the neighborhood project?
Alan, don't. Put down the phone.
Well, we understand each other. Now, let's go arrange my bail to get me out of jail, huh?
We're ready to move you to the courthouse.
Well, let's go. Partner.
Where did that come from?
Look, forget what I said. Okay, let's find that gas
station.
Frank,
right? You can't make a dig like that and then pretend you didn't say it.
That didn't mean anything by it.
You said I'm no father of the year. We both know it's a lousy father, Frank. I thought we were past that.
Maybe you were, but obviously I'm not, huh?
What do I have to do to make this up to you? What are you going to do? Print. I was a lousy father. I wasn't there in your childhood across my forehead.
Look,
that was your name, Frank?
Frank, forget it.
You want me to leave? I can just leave you here. I can disappear again. Leave you here
no.
and just go on.
No, I want you to stay.
Well, then act like it, Frank.
How do we get into this in the first place?
You got us into this. You said I was no father of the year.
Look, all I meant was you should pay more attention about putting gas
Frank,
in the car, okay?
Frank, you got my attention. Okay? Wish me luck. It's going to be on my gravestone. Rotten father ran out of gas.
Look, let's stay here, okay? I'll get
you. Now, wish me luck. You're no good father's coming back, you know?
Oh, man. Alan Spaulding could go back to jail.
Yeah, what do you know? Not that I'm surprised.
Yeah, it's not really earth-shattering. I mean, especially since we're away. Helps you keep some perspective on what's really important.
You know what? It certainly does. You know, we have our priorities in order. And who cares about some shady millionaire mogul when two of us can spend quality time with each other like this?
All right. Relax.
Yeah.
Luxuriate.
Yeah, that's right.
No decisions to make.
No.
Except when we're going to get out of bed.
Yeah, and where we're going to have dinner.
Right. And when we're going to hike or skydive or whatever.
Yeah.
I bet Nick has his hands full with this.
Oh, yeah, but he can handle it.
Yeah, no doubt.
There's no reason to call him and check up on him.
No, he's got the whole staff. Yeah. Tangy.
Yeah. You know, I just kind of wish, though, that he'd finished the article over here on 3 instead of over here on 5.
Boy, what's the difference? You still find it on 5.
Oh, you know what? You're right. I'm sorry. Here I am on my honeymoon, and I'm still editing. You have permission to tickle my toes if I try to do that again.
I'll remember that. When is the arraignment?
Right in the front here, sir, today.
I hope they remember to get a photographer down there. I mean, there's no pictures. And they better line up an interview with the DA before the thing really gets going.
Yeah, not to mention Alan Michael, I'm sure. He's got a few choice words to say about his uncle.
You know, it's a good thing that one of us doesn't want to go back for the story and the other one stay here on honeymoon.
Yeah, you know, you're right, because then that way we find out we're completely incompatible.
I would hate to find that out at this point.
Yeah, so would I. You know, Alan, throwing the risk of being a 2-time felon, he can go to slam for a long time now.
This is huge.
Yeah.
Huge. Do you believe it popped while we were away?
It's only the beginning.
I'll take care of the bill.
I'll drive the car around.
We can be out of here in 15 minutes.
Yeah, we'll make it back before the deadline.
Yeah. I love you.
Tangy, what you saw, when you saw Alan panic at being locked up was no act, please. That was very real.
The only thing real about Alan is his ability to manipulate people.
Oh, come on. Have you ever felt trapped? I mean, really trapped. Like you couldn't breathe. You were going to die if you
I
didn't get out of the air.
I have spent time in jail, Alex.
All right, but I'm not talking about jail.
So what are you talking about? Because I already know about Alan's 5 miserable years in jail.
You don't really know anything. I know you think you do, but you think Alan confided everything in you. He didn't tell you about what it was like for him to grow up, did he?
No, he didn't tell me about his childhood.
Well, I'm going to tell you about it right now, because this started way before Alan was even 5 years old. You see, our father used to lock him in a pantry.
Actually, it was nothing more than a dark little broom closet.
Well, that's child abuse.
Well, back then, you didn't call it child abuse. Our father was just considered a very strict disciplinarian. Determined to teach us both that we, well, must succeed, you know? Especially his son, of course. That was a way to make him a man, to lock him in his room until he was so paralyzed with fear that he literally could not breathe. Father would walk away, then he'd come back, and Alan would be screaming. I'd have to sit outside that door listening to him scream. I mean, screams of terror. Father would decree he cannot come out of there until he stops crying. This young man was such a sensitive boy. You don't understand. He lived for his father's loyalty, his love. One time I actually sneaked back down there. I got the key, opened the door, let Alan outside for a while, and I will never forget the look on his face.
Well, that's horrible.
Look, you see, Tanji, you could hold that key now if you wanted to. I mean, you could keep Alan from going into that special kind of hell he knows. And all you'd have to do is simply not testify.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to. I was going to knock.
It is all right.
I ran out of gas and.
You have a car.
Yeah. I was. It's back out on the road. I walked a ways. I did. I was hoping there was a gas station.
There is one. About 15 miles east of here.
Frank was right.
Excuse me?
Nothing. Can I use your phone?
There is one in the main house, but I do not think anyone is there.
Yeah, I know. I tried. Where am I?
Perhaps there is a map here, and I can show you. Forgive me for being so slow. I'm recovering from an injury I had a few weeks ago.
And don't get up. Don't.
They treated me like I was some dangerous criminal.
The judge was simply following standard procedure for a bail hearing, Alan.
Yes, well, I felt like I'd already been convicted. I mean, they impounded my passport, grounded my jet, and that bail was astronomical.
Yeah, well, I should be able to get that reduced after the preliminary hearing.
No, you're going to do better than that, Sid.
Alan, I'll do what I can.
You're going to get the charges dropped, every last one of them.
Yeah, well, that would be a hell of a lot easier to do if you hadn't spilled your guts about Brent to your girlfriend and your son.
Sid, your job is to keep me out of prison. Can you do that or not?
Well, there are ways that you can undermine the credibility of a witness.
For instance?
Tangi Hill. Yeah, given her personal relationship with you, Alan, she's particularly vulnerable to an aggressive cross-examination.
No, no.
Yeah, Alan, you know, I've done some research. You know, Tangi has this pattern of jumping from man to man.
That's not true.
It's how it looks, Alan. That's all that matters. I can use it against her on the witness stand. I can make her seem fickle, even promiscuous.
She's not, and I won't allow you to do that.
Alan, do you want me to keep you out of jail or not?
I want you to find another way. You will not hurt Tangi.
A few days ago, you tried to convince me that Alan was up to something, and I didn't believe you.
But you know me, I was angry. I didn't know what I was saying.
No, no, Alex. You said that he'd done something, and I would find out about it sooner or later. You were talking about Brent, weren't you?
Certainly not.
Alex, don't lie to me.
All right, look, I shouldn't have come down on you. I'm sorry. I just didn't think you cared at all about my brother. But now I am asking for your help.
You are asking me to perjure myself.
No, I'm asking you. You don't have to do anything. Just refuse to take the stand.
My childhood wasn't a picnic either. You don't see me hurting anyone.
But you see, I know Alan never intended to hurt you.
Alan did what he did to me. And to Lucy and to Alan Michael. He used us like pawns in a big, great chess game.
Okay, I was hoping that I could reach you somewhere in your heart, your feelings for him, but...
Alex, I'm just not playing these games. Your son warned me.
What, my son told you not to help me?
He told me that it's very easy to get sucked into the Spalding way of doing things, and he was right.
Well, I thought you loved the Spalding way of doing things. There's lots of money and power and jewelry and connections. I thought you laughed it up.
I was trying to stand by Alan so he would realize he didn't need all of that.
For heaven's sake, stand by him now when he does need you.
You know, honestly, when you go to the Spalding house, you should check your conscience at the door.
What, did my son feed you all of this?
No, Alex, this was my decision. I would have come to this no matter what Nick said.
So you're absolutely determined just to destroy my brother?
Those are your words, not mine.
Just what kind of a turncoat are you?
You know, I don't need this conversation again.
Yes, you do. Come on, I've listened to you bring this family down and berate it for long enough. Now you're trying to literally destroy my brother's life.
Don't drag me into this, Alexandra.
Well, like it or not, you're in it. You're part of this family. I couldn't even get through to Tangi Hill because you just spread around this anti-Spalding propaganda. I mean, how could you do this?
I just tell it like I see it.
Don't you dare use that tone of voice with me.
No. You really want to see your uncle go to prison? Do you really want to destroy everything that I love?
Oh, that's enough. You know something? I have had it up to here with you and your brother using the Spalding name to batter everybody into line. I am not playing that game anymore. What your brother did was as low as it gets. And I'll tell you something. I hope that Tangi takes that witness stand and she tells everybody the truth.
You really don't understand a thing about family loyalty, do you?
Oh, is this what you call family loyalty? A father stabbing his son in the back? The same man who stabbed his own nephew in the back to get power over his sister? Look, you don't have to tell me about this family, all right? I have been in it and I've been out of it. And out of it is definitely better. Excuse me, I have a piece to write.
Hello, Alexander. Things are definitely starting to happen.
Definitely.
When's the arraignment?
Here's the judge.
Now, when did he get released from the hospital? Did you get a quote before he got out?
Do you think they'll hold him without bail?
Wait a minute, okay? It's all right here.
I thought you two were going to be gone till the end of the month.
Holly got bored.
I thought you wanted to come back.
Two of a kind, I'll tell you.
How's Tangi holding up?
She was doing okay until my mother came in and worked her over. She's in your office.
Look, we can't print this.
What are you talking about?
Oh, what, are you crazy here? I mean, come on, Nick. Your personal feelings are all over this place. Does the word objective mean anything to you?
Hey, wait a minute. Every word of that article is true.
You know what? There's a difference between the word true and the word factual. Now, look, I understand your need to get back at your mother and your uncle here. That's okay with me, but not with our newspaper.
So Alex accuses you of stabbing Alan in the back and twisting the knife. And this is after you tell the police what Alan has admitted to you.
Was I wrong? Was I wrong to do that?
Listen, whatever happens, you're not the judge, you're not the jury. If he goes to jail, it won't be your fault.
Alex says it will kill him. Maybe she's right. Maybe I shouldn't testify.
I won't see Tangi torn apart on the stand.
Tangi's testimony could be devastating, Alan.
If she testifies at all, Sid.
Why wouldn't she?
Because she would have to come face to face with me in the courtroom.
Well, she had no problem talking to the police or the DA.
Yes, but that's different. She won't testify against me. She doesn't want to hurt me.
Oh.
I mean, there's no way she would do that.
Sounds like your ego talking, Alan.
She cares about me, Sid. When she demanded I tell her about Brent Lawrence, I told her the truth. Because I love her. And she knows that. She knows that I bared my soul to her. She would never use that against me, I know.
All right. Hope you're right. If Tangi doesn't testify and the police don't track down Brent's sister, state doesn't have much of a case.
What about Alan Michael?
His word against yours. And I think the odds are in your favor on that one, Alan.
Well, how did the bail hearing go?
Well, you wouldn't have to ask if you had been there. But I realize you have a very busy schedule. What was it, a hairdresser? Did you need a new outfit for court?
Oh, my dear brother. You're feeling better, aren't you? Got all that natural wit and charm back. Sid, may I have a moment alone with my brother?
Of course. I have to follow those motions anyway, Alan. Listen, I'll talk to you a little later. Don't go anywhere.
Well, if you weren't out primping or shopping, where the hell were you?
I was with Tangi.
Oh. I see, I see. So, she won't testify against me, will she? Because she cares for me. Isn't that what she said?
All right, Dad, I got the gas. Lucky for us, the station was open. What, do you sleep? Oh, man, now where is he?
Necessary.
You fainted.
I just got dizzy for a moment. It passed.
If you're sick, you shouldn't be alone.
I'd better.
Does nobody take care of you?
Everybody is out in the fields.
Hmm. I'll go get somebody.
No. It is fine. I just moved too quickly. The doctor has made me spend too much time in bed.
And there is someone to take care of me. I'll get some water.
I am thirsty. In the pitcher over there. We do not see many strangers here. What brought you to this part of the county?
I'm on a mission.
You are a minister. There are some who travel from community to community.
Nothing like that. It's, I'm looking for a woman. A woman who can help my daughter and the man she loves.
You have reason to think she is near here.
Well, actually, we're on our way to Gary. We think we'll find her there. We just can't go back to Springfield without her.
Springfield? Springfield.
You know Springfield?
Is that where you are from?
Well, yeah, I was born there, but I was away quite a few years.
Where?
You're traveling. Mostly traveling.
What is that?
It's a good luck charm for the road. It's, my father gave it to me as a christening present. About as close as I get to religion.
I think God knows who we are, whether we belong to a church or not.
Do you have a husband? I mean, is he out in the fields with the other?
I have no husband. Thank you for helping me back to bed. That was very kind. But I do not wish to keep you from your mission.
No, you're not.
You were looking for gasoline for your car.
When I arrived here, I was in a lousy mood. I just had a fight with my son. He's back in the car, and we were pulling each other's throats, and that must have been about my daughter. The last few weeks have been sort of tough, but it seems far away now. It's peaceful here.
I have found that too.
Oh, I'm sorry. I overstayed my welcome.
No, it is not that. I don't mean to seem inhospitable, but it is not proper for a man and an unmarried woman to be alone in the same room together.
Oh.
Whether one of them is a doctor, that's all right, or a minister.
I don't mean to get you in any trouble. Listen, I hate to leave you like this.
Someone will be by to check on me soon.
Oh, no, don't get up. Don't get up. I know. Find my way.
I'm steadier on my feet now. I will be all right. I'll show you the door. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Be well. I don't know your name.
Godspeed.
Look, Alan, there's no easy way to tell you this.
Alex, I know how you hate to admit that you're wrong. And believe me, I promise you that I will not say I told you so.
Alan, look, I gave you such a hard time about Tanji. I'm sorry.
Look, all is forgiven, Alex. Just tell me what she said. I'm very grateful to you for getting through to her when I wasn't able to.
Well, Alan, that's not quite what happened. Wish you could find some way to soften this.
Soften what?
Look, when I walked into the journal, I was praying, actually, that you were right about the girl. She really did love you.
She does.
Alan, for heaven's sakes, you're my brother. I love you more than anything else in the world. You know that. You know I want you to be happy. You know, for a change, I want you to find some joy in your
life. As long as it doesn't involve Tanji, right?
No. Actually, I would accept that if that were possible, but it's just not. Not anymore.
She's not going to testify against me, is she?
That's what she says she's going to do.
She can't.
Oh, come on. She wants revenge, Alan. I tried to talk to her. I couldn't get through to her at all.
I loved her. I thought she loved me. How could she change overnight?
I don't know. Maybe she never really cared for you. I don't know. Maybe you're just another trophy, another millionaire to add to the list. I don't know. Maybe when she found out she could have you, she didn't want you.
Alex, she is not like that.
Oh, come on. She spent her formative years with Roger Thorpe. That's enough to make any woman a man-hater.
Alex, you're exaggerating. Oh. She would not testify against me. You weren't listening to her. You were probably attacking her.
Grief, I've apologized about everything I ever thought of saying to her or did say to her.
You must have been there for hours, Alex.
All right, stop it. I ended up begging her out of any kind of love for her to have some understanding, but she wouldn't do that. I asked for just some human compassion. Now, look, Alan, I know you don't want to believe me, but I am truly, truly sorry, but that girl does not give a damn about what happens to you.
If I testify against Alan, he could go to prison, and it could kill him. If I don't testify, then he's let free. And he never pays for what he's done.
You know, you've just got to do what you know is right.
What Alan thinks is right and wrong is a very large gray area. I know what he did. And I know why. I mean, does that make any difference?
You know, we're through the same thing. I ask myself those same questions over and over again about Roger. Because even though I know he's fair to you, he uses people the same way Alan does. He manipulates. He twists the rules till you don't know where you stand. Your whole soul gets all tangled up in his.
Boy, don't I know that.
Badly. And I tried everything. I mean, I tried to forgive him. I tried to understand him. I refused to see him. I gave him ultimatums. I even nearly married him again.
But you didn't marry him. You married Fletcher.
Just in time before I sealed the deal with someone I would never be able to trust.
What did you do about the promises? You know, Alan told me, he promised me he was wrong, that he would change, that he would be different.
He used to swear the same things to me over and over again, and always at the exact moment I needed to hear it. Every time, same story. But I tell you this, if I had listened to myself from the beginning, I would have saved a whole lot of people a whole lot of trouble, including Roger and myself. So that's the best I can tell you. Listen to yourself.
We go with this article, you can kiss your family goodbye.
No problem.
Nick, you're mad. Believe me, I understand how easy it is to be mad at your mother or even your uncle. That's okay. But have you really thought about this? I mean, do you really want to blow up these bridges? Not to overquote Thomas Wolfe too much. Once again,
I don't want to go home again, okay? Look, don't you get it? I know exactly what I'm doing here.
I saw your mother, Alexandra, rush out of here just a little while ago. She was really mad. Now, you put this article in the paper with your name above the title, and you know what's going to happen? She's going to come back here and try to chop your head
off. You know something? Take the name off.
No byline.
Put by Nick McHenry. I never wanted to be a Spaulding in the first place.
It took you so long. You know, I was gonna leave you here, but I didn't want to listen to Mum's badgering.
Got a nap in here, friend?
There, in case you hadn't noticed, I got the gas. Right? Anyway. What are you doing?
Trying to figure out where we are.
Why? I got the gas here. We can leave now, okay? Listen, I don't want to see this place anymore. Can I have the keys, please?
Thank you. Ah, here we are. Goshen.
Goshen. I remember that.
Provided by Art to Wear. Glove collection by Finale.